Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to do a quick overview for the app for the Dreametech line of bots. This in front of me is for the Dreametech bot Z10 Pro. However, this is the same layout for the L10 Pro. The D9 is a little bit different, but some of the same concepts do transfer over. So I chose to do the one for the Z10 Pro since it has the most settings of all three robot vacuums. So let's go ahead and get started by talking about when you get the robot vacuum out of the box and you go ahead and power it on. After it's fully charged, you're going to want to send it out for a full mapping of your house. Now, I've already done that here. As you can see, my house is already mapped completely. But when you let it go out and map the entire house, it will automatically create a map that looks similar to this. Of course, it will be of your floor plan. It will go ahead and try to divide up all of your rooms automatically. Now, it doesn't do this perfectly, and you will need to edit those rooms if you want to divide them so you can do room cleanings, as you see I have done here. And that is where some of the trickiness comes into with these robot vacuums that are smart robot vacuums. So to start with, let's pretend that this has gone out and done a full house cleaning, and we want to go ahead and edit the map and straighten some of this up. Down in the lower left hand corner down here, you'll see map management. If you go ahead and click on that, it's going to bring up your map. The first thing you're going to see, if you have a multi-floor home, you'll want to enable multi-floor maps up here at the top. I do not. I have a single story house, so I do not have that turned on. That would allow you to create up to four maps for up to four floors of your house, and the robot vacuum will automatically recognize when it is on a different floor. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to click on this map here and edit it. You can rename the map if you have multiple floors. That is the first thing I would do. If you did have a multi-story house, I would name my map based on the floor. So going into the map here gives you a few options to choose from for dividing the map. First, up in the top right hand corner, you have the ability to rotate the map. If it is in the wrong direction, it will let you rotate it. You do also have the ability to restore a previous map. You can restore the map that you click on. That is the other option up here. But here's what we're here to look at. The option down here at the bottom to merge, split, or rename your rooms. So let's start with merge. If we want to merge a room, we'll first click merge, and it will want you to select two rooms to merge. For instance, let's say that we want to merge this room and this room. Now, when I'm done, it will merge these two rooms together. Okay, now you can see now this is all one color, so it merged these two rooms together. You may have to merge a couple of rooms together in order to properly split them. Now, if we want to re-split these, we'll hit choose split. We'll select the one room. It's going to put a line up here on your map, and you're going to want to place that line exactly where you want it to split. And what you'll notice is a dotted line wherever it is not going to split, and a solid line where it would split. And so right here is my doorway. And so right here looks good. So I'm going to check yes. And it should re-split that room for us again. And so when you first get your room division, you'll notice that some of them are jagged, kind of like this right here. And so you'll need to fix that. Now that's not too big of a deal, this jagged line right here, but I'll show you how to go ahead and fix that. So once again, to fix this, we're going to merge these two rooms here and here. Check yes. Okay, now that these two rooms are one solid color, we're now going to want to split them again. So choose that one room, which is A. Get that as close to the doorway as possible for a split. Okay, now you can see the jagged line is gone and we have properly split that room. Okay, so that is how you merge and split. The other option down here at the very bottom is the rename. And that they give you some canned names to choose from down here at the bottom where you can just basically name your room. Unfortunately, they do not allow a custom name. So if you choose, say, bedroom, select what area. I want to choose this bedroom. It will rename that by putting an icon up there. I wish they gave you an option to do a custom name. They do give you a few choices here, but no customization. So you have to kind of go with what they have. Okay, now back to the main screen, and once you've done dividing up and naming all of your rooms like you see here, let's talk about some other options. There are some places that you may not want your robot vacuum to go. For instance, I have a sofa here in my living room, and when the recliners are kicked up, I don't want the robot vacuum to go under it and get caught. So what I do is I choose a no-go zone. All right, so right here you get a few options for your virtual wall and no-go zone. Let's start with virtual wall. So if you select a virtual wall, one will come up that you can move it around and adjust the size of your virtual wall here. Even gives you a little zoom so you can zoom in and see where you're putting it. And I can put this anywhere, which means that I will not allow the robot vacuum to go beyond this wall. So let's say that I want this virtual wall to be over here. Now the robot vacuum will not go over on this side of the wall because it cannot cross this virtual wall. The other option is a no-go zone. So if I don't want it to go, say, under my bed, which is back here, I'm going to make this the size of my bed, and now the robot vacuum will not go anywhere in this red square. There is one more nice option they give you, which is a no mop zone. It is here purple. So I have here on my living room floor, I have a carpet that sits in front of my recliner couch here, and no matter what, I don't want it to mop here. So if it has the mopping pad attached, it will not mop right here. Of course, it will vacuum if it doesn't have the mopping pad attached, but that basically will keep your robot vacuum with a wet mop off of your carpet or any area that you don't want it to mop. So those are your three options for your no-go zone, your no-go line, and your no mopping area. Once you're done, make sure you hit the check mark in the top right-hand corner to save your settings. All right here on the front screen, another option that you're going to want to look at is your cleaning mode. So click on that and you get two different settings. One is the suction setting, going from quiet, which is the lowest suction setting and also the quietest mode, standard, strong, and turbo being the most strongest level and also the loudest level. Water flow settings, low, medium, and high. Those are your settings that you can choose when you're sending it out. The other options here on your front screen is you have a room selection. So if I just want to send it out to clean my living room and my hallway, I can do that. Now, if I have a mopping pad attached here, unfortunately, it doesn't tell you if you have a mopping pad attached, but I know I don't, so the water flow settings don't take place here. But if you did have a mopping flow attached, this is where you would choose your settings here for that. So if I wanted to send it out right now, I could send it out for these two rooms and do a cleaning for room cleaning. I can also choose up to two room cleanings. So if I want to clean this and have it go over it twice, I check this box right here to toggle between one and two for room cleanings. And up here at the top, it's telling you room J and B. First, you're going to do J, and then you're going to do B in that order, and it's going to clean those two times. So if I hit the play button right now, it will go out and clean both of those, and it'll go over the area two times. The next option is all. If I click the play button right now, the DreameBot will go out and clean my entire floor plan. And so my other option is a zone cleaning. So if I want to do a zone cleaning, here I have the option to set up a zone where I would go send the robot vacuum to this area, and I have the option to choose between one and two times for it to pass over this one area. Let's say I've spilled a big mess or something and I want it to just go there and not vacuum my entire living room. That might be a reason why you want to do a zone cleaning instead of a specific room cleaning. All right, so let's take a look at the settings menu. And up here in the top right-hand corner, the three dots, we'll click on that. And this brings up our settings menu. We'll take a look at some of the options here. Device settings is somewhere that you may want to go quite frequently. Make sure the vacuum is in the right time zone. 3D high precision obstacle avoidance is an option for the Z10 and the L10 only. Turning this on means the front laser guidance system that's on the front of the robot vacuum will avoid objects that it thinks is something it should avoid. Now you do have the ability down here, I'll talk about that in a second, to set the sensitivity on that. Voice and volume, that's pretty standard. Just the volume level when the robot vacuum talks to you, not the volume of the actual suction motor. Notifications, if you want to turn that on or off, you can do it there. Pretty self-explanatory. Carpet boost. When the robot vacuum gets on a rug or transitions from floor to carpet, if your setting is not on the highest settings for suction, it will automatically boost up the power. That is a setting I recommend turning on. It works pretty well. Identification sensitivity. Right now I have it set to low. Their suggestion is high sensitivity is suitable for low power carpets, while low sensitivity is appropriate for high power carpets. I set mine to low at all times and it works just fine. Child lock, I like this option a lot. Child lock is something that turns on. The robot vacuum has buttons on top of it, so if a kid walks up and starts pushing buttons, it's not going to send out the robot. So turning this on means that basically you need to hold the dock button for 3 seconds on the robot vacuum if you want to turn it off. I have 3 cats in my house and they have a tendency to get on top of the robot vacuums, walk on it, crawl on it, and I've seen them send it out for a full house cleaning before. So I always turn this on so they don't have accidental problems like that. Resume cleaning mode. If you have a large house and it takes more than one battery to get around the house, this is what something that you're going to turn on. When the battery is too low, it'll go back to the dock. It'll charge up. When the battery is sufficient, the robot will continue cleaning. And it will continue doing this until it is done cleaning. Do not disturb mode is a nice option to have turn on, especially if you have the Z10 Pro with the auto empty dock. It'll basically, if you're cleaning and it is between these hours, it will not do a auto empty of the base, and it will also not send it out for multiple cleanings. And you can set your hours for when you want it to be in do not disturb mode. Mop cleaning mode is an interesting feature because the robot vacuums from Dreametech do not have a self-cleaning mop. You have to clean the mop pads yourself. This option is here for if you want it to go out for a certain period of time and come back to the dock for you to clean the mopping pad and then it will finish the mopping. This is something that you want to turn on. I just clean a couple of rooms at a time and then clean the mopping pad, and then that's how I do it, so I don't turn that feature on. So here on the Z10 Pro, we do have an auto empty dock, so we'll run through that real quick. You can turn that on or off. If you turn it on, every time it goes out, it will clean the Z10 and empty it into the auto empty dock after either one cleaning task, two, or three. If you're doing multiple rooms or you have a lot of dust and debris in your house, I would suggest setting it to every single time I do on this one. That way it keeps it empty. Also, if you want to run it manually, this is where you will go to run the auto empty bin manually. Schedule cleanup. If you want to set up some schedules, it allows you to basically set different times for different cleanings, and also lets you set the water flow and the vacuum suction. How many times you want to repeat it. The start time lets you choose between a room cleanings or just all cleaning. It's pretty handy for some people who want that option. Personally, me, I just send it out when I'm ready for it to clean. Here you can see the cleaning history. As it's gone through the house, it will show you the details of what it did in a complete map format here, highlighting the rooms that it cleaned. That's a very nice feature to have. Also tells you the square meter, or unfortunately they don't let you choose square feet with the Dreametech, but you have to do a conversion. It tells you how long and how much space it cleaned. Okay, accessory usage. This is something that you want to pay attention to. It tells you the filter life, the side brush, how long it is going to last for, the main brush, how many hours approximately left on the main brush roller before you need to replace it, and also the sensors around the robot vacuum and when you need to clean them. It is important to clean them to make sure they continue to work successfully. The remote control is more of a kind of a novelty thing, in my opinion. It allows you to use your app here to make the robot vacuum go forward, turn left, or turn right. Locate my robot is simply something that you will choose if your robot vacuum is lost somewhere in your house and you want it to send an audible tone to it. Click this and it will let you know where the robot vacuum is, that is, if it's not dead. Here's where in the general settings you can change the device name right here. Location management is just settings for your robot vacuum to tell the robot vacuum, tell you where the robot vacuum is in your house. Not all that helpful. Device sharing. I don't use that and actually not really sure what that is for. If you know, drop a comment below because I don't know. Intelligent scene is automation, but it's very limited. For instance, if I choose plus here, I can do an if and then statement here, but the only thing I really get is a schedule. If I choose a robot vacuum, the only option I have is do something if a cleanup completes, then do this. Like send me a notification, which it does anyhow. So I haven't found this to be very useful at all. I wish they would do some more stuff with this. The other option here is firmware updates. You want to go here every so often to make sure that you are on the latest version of firmware. Help and feedback. This is somewhere where you can give Dreametech feedback, and there is also some common problems, and help you solve some of your problems right here. I like that they have that fully fleshed out. More settings, really just some basic stuff here. Plugin version, security settings, legal information, add a shortcut to your home screen here on your phone, basic stuff. And also you can delete device from this app if you say you sold it and gotten rid of it and you don't want to use it anymore. Going back here to the home screen, we'll show you a couple more things and we'll get this wrapped up. So up here at the top, you can see that this is the status for the last cleaning. It cleaned 7 meters, took 7 minutes. That's 1 meter per minute cleaning. Right now you can see the battery status as at 100%. And down at the bottom right-hand corner, you can confirm that charging is complete. So the D9 is a little bit different right here. If you want to see a video on that, I can do a separate video. It's basically the same, but if you do want to see another video on that, drop a comment below. If you have any questions, feel free to drop those below. I'll do my best to answer them. I appreciate you watching this video. Make sure you subscribe for future videos like this, and I appreciate you. Take it easy, everyone. Bye-bye.